Over time, things change in medicine. So patients change, our treatments change, the modalities we have for investigating patients change, society, even environment changes. So things that may have worked or may have been applicable in the past may be completely non-applicable in the present. So we have no idea what those influences might be that change things within patient care, but they definitely exist. And if we don't think about it, think outside the box, think about what the standards are and whether they make any sense in today's world, we will never be able to improve what we do with patients. Once you start to get in depth and analyze things, many things have no evidence around them. Many things are anecdotal, based on what I was always taught, based on what at one point made sense, but currently may not. So, for example, the world that I live in right now is mostly the area of venous thromboembolism. And when I was a trainee, we admitted patients to hospital and they were in intravenous heparin therapy for 14 days. But it became obvious after a few days that the patients were well. And yet we told them they had to stay in bed and they had to stay on this IV drip, but they looked good. So you're wondering, why are we doing this? And so that kind of inquiry eventually led to us realizing that we could try and shorten the duration of therapy. So we did studies that shortened the duration of therapy from 14 days down to 5 to 7 days. And that was effective. And then we looked at it and we thought, well, why are we admitting them to hospital? And a new medicine came along known as low molecular weight heparin, which was not intravenous, it was a subcutaneous injection. Although actually unfractionated heparin itself could have been given subcutaneously, but we chose to give it IV for reasons, again, that aren't entirely clear. But with unfractionated, with low molecular weight heparin now available, and the fact that it could be given once a day, we thought, well, why are we even keeping people in hospital? So let's look at whether we can send them home. And so we started evaluating that. And you know, at the beginning, it was very scary. So I remember the first few patients we put this on, and we said it was a randomized trial where we were going to send people home or keep them in hospital. And one of the parameters was if they have comorbidities that need to keep them in hospital, then we could keep them in hospital. But that was a vague criteria. And I remember once we had this woman who was quite young, 33 years old, very big DVT, and we thought, wow, we can't send her home because, you know, it's a big DVT. So the first day we kept her in hospital, and the next day we realized that she was doing fine. And we realized that, again, it was some of our built-in biases existed, and that's why we kept her in hospital. Anyway, so from there, when I came here in Ottawa to Ottawa in 1994, we started on trials where we were sending most of our patients home with DVT. And then we started realizing, well, we don't have to send in people in hospital with PE either because they're stable too. So we started sending those people home. And over time, we realized that this completely shifted the way we cared for patients. And I remember with the pulmonary embolism, at first we were considered radicals. And a friend of mine went to a course in Boston and they said, those radicals up in Canada actually treat these people at home with their pulmonary embolism. And that's just crazy practice, right? And now that's what we do in at least half of our patients, maybe more, who have a pulmonary embolism. So we got there by questioning, by looking at what we do, by using common sense, by wondering where the standard came from, by looking at the evidence in the literature to see if it was supported.